Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we'll learn how to create campaign influence records for an even distribution model. If you haven't watched our other videos on campaign influence, we highly recommend you watch those first. You'll find the links to those videos in the description below. They cover the basics and give you a solid foundation of how campaign influence works. Let's hop over to Salesforce and see how to update our flow for an even distribution attribution model. All right, here we are in Salesforce, and we are going to set up our even distribution model to be our default model first. So you're going to go to Model Settings and edit this, and then you'll want to check the box for default model. The reason why we're making the even distribution model the default model is so that we can see the campaign influence records get created right from the opportunity related list. It's just going to make testing a little bit easier for us while we go through this. Now, we're going to update four different flows in this video. If you didn't complete the steps in the first touch campaign attribution model, that means you don't have the flows that we're going to update in this video. You will need to complete all the steps in that video so that you have the backbone of the flows in place. Even if you don't want to do the first touch model, you need to see the methodology that we went through and how we set up all the flows to query all the campaign influence records and the flows to fire from opportunity contact roles and campaign member record creation. All right, so the first flow that we're going to update is our opportunity contact role flow. We're going to update this one right here called Opportunity Contact Role Created Campaign Influence Automation. We're going to open this up. And we're going to scroll down here and we're going to add an outcome to this decision. This is going to be called Even Distribution. Now, in an even distribution model, we're going to give equal influence percentages to all of our campaign influence records. So you're going to see how all that works. For this particular decision, we're going to copy exactly what we're doing here for our last touch. And we're just getting the developer name of the campaign influence model record that we are looping through up here. And we're going to look for that to be called even distribution. And this is coming from the API name of the custom model that you created in the campaign influence settings. Now we're going to connect this element over to here, right? And then we need to make one other update so that this works. We're going to update this decision element over here. And we're going to look for the developer name of the model. This one right here, campaign influence model, developer name equals even underscore distribution. And this is going to be an OR. And then we'll update the name here. All right, we'll do a save as there, save. So what we're doing here is we are getting all of the campaign members that the contact in the opportunity contact role record is related to. And then we're looping through all of those and we're creating campaign influence records. Now the criteria that we're using here is exactly the same as what we used in the first touch campaign attribution model, where we're looking for campaign members that have a status of responded, and we are looking for their created date to be greater than 180 days before the op created date. So we'll activate this, and then we're ready to create our next flow. Our next flow is on the campaign member. So we're going to scroll down here and we're going to go to campaign member, campaign influence record automation. We'll open this up. And the same thing here, we're going to add an outcome to our decision. And then we're going to copy this right here too, because we just want the developer name to be even underscore distribution. And then we're going to connect this down here. Now we don't need to do any of this sorting stuff that's happening that we're doing in the first touch, last touch, because in the even distribution campaign attribution model, if you remember, any campaign that this contact role is associated with is going to be added as a campaign influence record to the opportunity. So it doesn't care if it was the first one, it doesn't care if it was the last one, it just cares if it was campaign member was created 180 days prior to the op created date and their status was responded. So we'll do a save as on here. We'll activate this one and then we'll go to our next flow. Our next flow is opportunity contact role deleted master flow. All right, we're gonna scroll down here and we're gonna add another outcome. This is gonna be even distribution. We'll copy this here. And we're gonna look for it to say even distribution. Okay. Now, if you remember, this flow is deleting the campaign influence records whenever an opportunity contact role is deleted. And then we're looping through the existing campaign influence records to see if any exist, because we have to recalculate the influence percentages for the remaining campaign influence records. So that's what this flow is doing. It's then sending it to a subflow that's then doing those calculations. So we're going to copy this decision element here. And then we'll update all the names and the value here to look for even distribution. Okay, then if that text collection variable does not contain even distribution, we're going to send it over here and it's going to map the variables as needed and then send it to the subflow to recalculate our influence percentages. So we'll save this, activate this. All right, let's go to our final flow. Now we're going to go to our campaign influence percentage automation flow. This is the subflow that the last flow, the opportunity contact role deleted flow, is pushing records to. All right, in here, you guessed it, we're gonna add another outcome. And we're gonna copy this right here. So we wanna look for this variable to equal even distribution. So this is one of the variables that we're passing from our two other record triggered flows into this subflow. And now we're gonna copy what we've built for our first touch and last touch, because it's gonna work exactly the same. So we're getting all of the existing campaign influence records here and we're gonna filter them to have a look for the ones that have a model name of even distribution. So we'll copy this and we'll just name everything properly here. And then we need to leave that. That's filtering, that's perfect. Model name equals even distribution, so that's perfect. Now let's copy this assignment. and we're gonna rename this. And then what this is doing is it is assigning the count of this collection filter to this variable. So we need to change this to look for the even distribution collection filter. So let's look for that. So it's this one right here. All right. Next, we need to copy this flow. So this flow is going to loop through our collection filter for our even distribution records. So we'll change this. And we're gonna select that one that says even distribution. And last step is to assign our fields. Okay, so what we're doing is we're assigning the campaign influence ID and the influence percentage to the campaign influence records that we want to update the influence percentage for. So all I need to do here is update the ID here to reference the collection filter, the current loop collection filter of the even distribution record that's coming in here. So it's that one. So let's just make sure that looks right. Should say loop filtered campaign influence even distribution. So we're good there. And then that's going to go into this update campaign influence records since we're adding all the records to this collection right here. So we can leave all that the same. It's all good. We will save this and activate it. All right, so we've updated all of our flows to account for our new even distribution campaign attribution model, and now it's go time, ready to test this out. All right, so this opportunity doesn't have any contact roles. We've got our even distribution model set as our default model. So we expect whenever we add Danny that all of the campaigns that Danny is associated with, that where she has a created date greater than 180 days, before the op created date, we should see all those campaign influence records get created, and we do, yay! All right, so we see 5 campaign influence records getting created, and let's look at their first associated dates. So our op created date is 1/10/2024. So we can see all of the first associated dates are actually after the op created date. So let's go check out Danny's contact, and let's just look at the contact history and see if there's any campaigns that are missing from here. And there's one, but that's because it's out of the date range. So whenever we set the criteria for querying our campaign member records, we only went 180 days prior to the op created date. Remember all that criteria? So this one is out of that time frame, so it wouldn't count as influence based on the criteria that we set. So having 5 campaigns in our even distribution model is absolutely correct. And then we have influence percentages that are associated. So each one gets 20% because it's an even distribution model. So that one is perfect. Let's go ahead and delete Danny and just make sure that all of those campaign influence records are indeed deleted as well. All right, perfect, they were. All right, let's add Danny back. And then we're gonna add Danny to another campaign, and let's just make sure that we see another campaign influence record get created here. See if I can pick a campaign she's not a part of yet. So ensure alert, we'll pick that one. And then I'm gonna choose a status responded. remember the criteria we look for is looking for that responded checkbox, not necessarily for the status to equal responded. Okay, so we've added that. Let's go back over here and let's check to see if this went to 6, which it did, and our influence percentages all recalculated. So all this is working awesome. This is so exciting. All right, let's go ahead and add another contact role. Let's add Bryn. And then we see Bryn. 2 records came in for Bryn. And if I remember correctly, Bryn only has 2 campaign history records. Let's check that out. Yep. And the first associated date, this one is in November, which is a month and a half before the op created date. So that's within the 180-day threshold. So this is correct. And then we see our campaign influence percentages all recalculated perfectly. All right, so this looks like it's all working really well. Now let's go check out our report. So we've got a campaign influence report here. We've got 3 different models working, well, actually 4 if you count the primary campaign source model that's always going to be there. So we've got our first touch, our last touch, and our primary campaign source model all in here. And you can see that the first touch records and the last touch records are all getting created correctly. You can see first touch for Danny is the risk-wise. So let's just look over at Danny and just confirm that that is the first touch, which is correct. And then let's go check for Bryn, the first touch. So the first touch for Bryn should be the 2024 cover care. And that is correct. And then if we check the last touch, we have 2 records there for this opportunity. So for Danny, 2024 insure alert. So that should be the last touch. So we go check that right there, insure alert, that's perfect. And then for Bryn, the last touch should be secure guard. Let's just confirm that, and that is correct. So we've got all of our flows firing correctly. We've got our first touch, last touch, and even distribution models all show records. So we can now look at our campaign attribution from 3 different angles, which is super exciting. And then if you wanted to change which model is showing in your campaign influence related list, it's as easy as updating the default model in the model settings. So you can just go to, let's come back here and show you what that looks like. We'll go to our model settings and let's make the first touch the default model. So nothing happens to any records whenever you change the default. It just changes what you see from the opportunity campaign influence related list, as well as on the campaign influence related list on the campaign, as well as which campaigns contribute to the metrics on the campaign record page. So we have this all working great. Nice work. I know this is a lot of work. Hope you get some awesome reporting out of it.
That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to work with a weighted campaign influence model. We will explore applying a weighted distribution percentage to campaign influence based on the campaign occurrence. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.